Hey guys, Damon at Black Warrior Lures. Back up here on my favorite part of the river, we're gonna do some jugging. There's an old dam here. We're gonna set up some jugs on each side of that dam. Now, I was looking at the sonar here a minute ago. You know, it's kind of cramped to look at it right now. But this is the old dam, and there's channel markers where they blasted the dam out in the middle of the channel. Now, I'm gonna run jugs on each side of the old dam. This side of the dam has not been dynamited, so it's really shallow. It comes up real shallow, about 20 feet deep, comes up to about 10, and drops back down to about 20 foot, something like that. So again, very shallow. But right where this marker is, that's where the markers are, that's where the barge traffic goes through, main boat land. I don't wanna put jugs way out there, because that just won't be, that just wouldn't be kosher or whatever. But what we're gonna do is we're gonna bait up some old brim and bluegill that we had here. It's on one hook there. We're gonna do our circular pattern. I don't know if you guys have ever seen me do that, but what I do is come here like so, and we've got some old bluegill here that's been just sitting in the fridge. And what we'll do is line up ourselves with the dam kind of comes at a diagonal angle here. What we'll do is sort of drop this guy right here, right there. Right? And then guess what we'll do? The easiest way to do it, this motor, just, you know, the old man of death or death spiral, they tell you, works perfectly with this. So what I can do is kill that thing hard over like that. We'll come right back over the same spot there, and we can make small adjustments. So I can get another jug prepped while we're getting ready. So there's the other jug there. There's the channel marker there. The dam kind of runs along this way. So a little bit slow now because I'm having to talk and do it all at the same time. These are just old pieces of brim that I've had caught, because, you know, catfishing and brim fishing kind of go hand in hand, guys. So what we'll do is, once again, get this guy out in the water. You know, unspread like that. And we can do this fast enough. Like that, okay? So that's one on that side of the dam, and one on this side of the dam. So what we'll do is, we'll keep my towel there, go back around. These are the bamboo jugs that you guys saw me dealing with. So I kind of have to use my elbow with this thing too. It's a little bit ungraceful, but I find that this motor, sorry for, you know, I got to keep my head kind of on a swivel, you know, because I don't want to run into anybody. I'm out here during the week. I find that jugging during the week is the best time to do it, on the weekends when you have a lot of rod and reel fishermen. You know, I don't want to get in their way. So, you know, you just pick your time you're going to jug. There's a nice, big, fat, ugly piece there, boy. So we can catch something. And so we're going to go here and back to this. Oh, gosh. Got all my daggum juice. Alright, so now, again, we're going to just put it in there. Okay, let's get back here. We're a little off here. Let's get this out. Watch the tail there. And so it's 1-2. Get another one on that a little bit further up. So So it's work. I mean, jug fishing is work, guys. It's an artisan form of fishing where it's basically a vertical trot line, is what it really comes down to. The thing I like about these bamboo things is that a lot of people, some people say that, well, you can't see them. Well, I can see them just fine because I know what they look like, and they look like just basic pieces of wood, so it's a little bit camouflaged. Well, fine with me. Legal to use bass, so we'll just, I had a bass, but I used to throw him back out with a pump or whatever. I didn't think about that, I just cut up all the rim, so now this is all cut up bluegill, except that one. It's perfectly legal in Alabama to use cut bluegill for catfish as bait, you know, so that's fine. So check your regs there. Some states don't want you using cut bluegill, some states don't mind, but in Alabama it's perfectly fine to use bluegill, sunfish, all that kind of stuff for, it's legal, so, you know, no worries, really. And so we're just gonna be going around in circles until we get from that point all the way to the shoreline. And then what we'll do is just come back and do some, brim fishing, basically, off these walls and things that you saw me do last week. Okay, so we'll get that guy out there, and the line will stretch out, bam, just let him go like that. Back up on the lake again, on the upper part of the river. I always call those rock brim. I guess they call them red ears. I'm not sure. They seem to like hanging around these rocks. As you can see, we're up on the rocks, drifting on the rocks. And didn't bring my other cooler, so I got to share my water and my fishing all in one thing. It's not the most sanitary thing, but we're doing the same thing. So let me get back on now we're on our oars. See, that way we can just let the wind and the current drift us back. If we get a little too close, all you got to do is just a couple paddle strokes back and you'll be fine. And we got plenty of bait here. I actually restocked this with bait, just this morning before it came out. From the big bucket. Little guy. Seems like the bigger ones are a little bit further downstream. But we switched to our Phillipson fly rod here, and it's got the 4-pound test line, and it's not high vis. I don't think the bluegill care about the line, but it seems like they're taking it a little bit more readily with this line than they were the high vis, so who knows. And then I think what's most likely is it's about 30 inches here instead of my normal foot. There's almost a foot and a half, not a foot and a half, there's almost 3 feet rather, between the sinker, which is 3/8 ounce, and the float there. And it's getting hung up a lot less, and I think there's just more hydrodynamic forces that keep the weight off the bottom. So we're, sometimes when you're out here, vary your techniques. So we just plopped it right there like that. And drop shot. Ooh, drop shot drifting for brim. Fly rod. Black soldier flies. It works, folks. I'm telling you, it works. I was up by the dam doing it, and then could only hook into the smaller ones up by the dam. But down here, a little bit lower, just put some fresh bait on. Getting to the bigger ones, so I think the combination of the weeds and the rocks make it work down here for the bigger brim. Up there by the dam, it's just all rocks, and it's not very deep. Here, it's deeper. I mean, like a lot deeper, like 20, 30 foot deep. And, oh, look at that. I just saw a snake up there. Yeah. And these oars are annoying me to no end. Pull back a little bit. Try not to make much noise, but kind of hard to do because I have to do things the old-fashioned way. And so, again, just pitching it down in there. Oh, come on, seriously? Right now in the weeds like that, and something's already got it, something's already hitting it. Took it away from him. He's still chasing it though. There we go, he just took it. He just took it. See, fly rod. See, there it goes right there. Just, I mean, again, just pitching it in around the weeds and the stumps and this rock. You see this sheer face here, but I'm just doing it drop shot. That's a nice bull brim there. Number 10, 3366 hook. Must add. Eagle Claw makes one, but I like the Mustad version better. Ugh, had a towel somewhere. Yep, there you go. And so there you have it. And all we're doing is, let's say we start getting too close to the bank, the wind is kind of pushing us toward the bank, and the current's pushing us downstream. So all we do is get on the oars, and we just do a couple of nice long strokes, about like that. Just get us back out a couple of more boat lengths, and it'll let us drift on some more, you know. And then, all right, so that's fun. So we're going to get back on it here. I almost always put some fresh bait on here. But anyway, and there we go. Get right back on them. And again, we put some jugs down out by the old dam, which were probably another mile. We went up a couple of miles up to the main dam and started drifting from the main dam all the way back to where we originally set out our jugs. Oh, wow. You're right there off that sheer face wall. See what we can do there. Not sure how deep it is right there, but we're just gonna fish it like so. Get it. Oh, so I'm already getting hits. I mean, I'm getting hits. There it goes. Well, anyway. Must not be as deep there as I thought it was. Alright, just like I said, much better rod here for brim. Alright, drop shot drifting, baby. Drop shot. Brim. That's what Dad used to say. Brim. Now, I'm always amazed. The only place I hear them called brim is down here in the South, in Alabama. You go anywhere else, everybody calling them bluegill and and sunfish, and they call them stuff like perch. It's like, the heck are you people talking about? Oh, they're talking about brim. Now, brim, overseas, brim is a whole different kind of fish, you know. It's like a saltwater fish, and that's what they... fish with over there. I mean, they catch brim in salt water in Australia. And so I guess when you say bluegill, it definitely clarifies what you're talking about. Well, we call them brim. I've gotten in the habit of calling them bluegill because that's what most people around the country and here, at least here in the United States, call them. And dadgummit, I can't see the line at all. Okay, there it is. Okay, I'm gonna rebait, get going again, and I'll be right back. A running jug right there, but here we got another one. Drop shot just off the weeds there. You can catch them like this, man. You can catch them. You can either go home and cook them, which I'm gonna probably do some of these because I ain't got to eat, I ain't got to buy them, you know. And we took some of these last week, and the ones we caught last week, as you remember, we're just using them for bait right now. I mean, we're just using them for bait on the jugs just down the way here, another quarter mile or so. We'll just re-rig here. And so, I mean, that's how that's working. But anyway. I'll get back with you. Another one. You don't catch them, baby. None of this ain't no monsters, but we can get us a few sandwiches off them. Get about 3-4 of them together. We can get us a sandwich. Sandwich. Boom. Drop shot drifting, baby. All right, I don't know how many this makes, but we ain't nowhere near our limit. In Alabama, it's just 50. It's 50. So I know we ain't nowhere near that. So we'll probably just, you know, clean them the old-fashioned way, just scale them and guys, some of them are just dying. These oars are just getting in my way. Annoying me to no end. But anyway, get right back on them here. I much prefer a bait feeder reel, spinning reel, to this standard regular one. I don't know, it's just, I need a little bit more line. Seriously? See, if I had my Akuma Avenger, that wouldn't have done that. But this stinking Shakespeare Cirrus, well. Okay. Oh, I'm gonna reel that guy back in. Try it again. Don't be in fear, you know, don't be afraid of moving. You know, moving fast. I mean, you just, the whole point is it's the old school thing, you know, cover a lot of water. That's exactly what we're doing. We're covering as much water as we possibly can. Damsel flies all around still. Oh, come on, don't get hung up. If I don't get any hits like that, I'll just re-up and pitch back in there. So, you know. Right there, just like that. We can already getting a hit right there. You see that? May have already routed me. Oh gosh, seriously. I have lost more gear today than I have in a long while. But we're catching them, so if you're catching them, just re-rig and get back after it. Got another one. I don't think he's a big one. Well, none of them have been really big today, but it's not too bad. Oh! Oh, come on now. But anyway, there we go. And, there we go. See, we're just passing the old bridge, the dam piling, and guess what? We got another one. It works, man, it works. Probably need to go ahead and try to motor up and get our jugs back. We got a lot of fish to clean when we get home. It's all right, though. Didn't have to buy it. All right. Can't get a pitch another one out there and just see what we can do there. Just right here, nothing fancy. Come on now, you gotta be kidding me, right? Oh. Yeah, fishing line gets tangled on everything, even itself. All right, let's see if we can target just this side of that dam or whatever. Something like that. See what happens. Just sort of dragging it, you know. I can see several of my jugs here. I think a lot of them are lined up, butted right up against the old dam there. I'd imagine there's one way under there. I don't know how I'm going to get him out. There we go again. You can see, you may be able to see him there. Shell cracker there, baby. That's a shell cracker. Or at least a female. Kind of have a hard time telling the difference between a female brim and a shell cracker, but there we go, right there. It's not a bad eating size. Like we've been saying all day. I think this is just a female. Female brim. All right. This method works. Oh. Once again, long casts off into these weeds, off these rocks. I had to say it, but the 4-pound line seems to be outperforming the 6-pound line. And here he goes right here. You can see him. He's there we go. Once again, drop shot. Reels him in. Brim. Brim. Once again, drop shot, reels him in. This method works, folks. Try you one. That's why I like the long 8-foot rod, man, because a little 6-foot rods, 4-foot light, ultra light rods don't cast long enough for me, man. I got to have something where I can do just what I'm doing right now. Long, controlled, accurate casts. I'm way back off here and I'm catching, and I'm casting right off those weeds. I don't know how far that is. I don't know, a few yards. I mean, right, you see how it landed just on this side of those weeds. See, he's already getting a hit, right? And it works, so he may already be hooked. Yep, he's hooked. Ooh, he's got a little bit of weight on him. He's swimming toward me now. Oh, he's going lateral. Five-sixth weight fly rod blank. Fiberglass. Want to build me another one. All right. I think you got a nice one. Yeah. Boom. 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 You see, we're getting too close now to the bank. Boom. All we do is haul off like this. And I like that 3/8 ounce weight a lot better than I do the eighth or the quarter. Well, I didn't even try the eighth. I tried the quarter and hated it. So I didn't figure there was any point in going down even lighter. Now, if I did some bobber fishing, I would probably go down to the eighth. Nothing. Nothing on the jugs. But remember the same sort of circle of death thing I was talking about? It applies right here as well. I just, when I gather them up, I just let it hard over like that, and it does fine. But anyway. Catching brims from these waters, so you can return the carcasses back, so it's not really. It's usually this bait, I suppose. You know. It's going to, there's another one straight downstream here. That's how I get them. I like them because they're a little bit camouflaged in terms of these jugs, right? I mean, you won't see them unless you just know where I put them. And here's another one. Bam. No, just nothing. Head on a swivel just in case there's other boats coming or whatever, but you know, just nothing there. Just kind of wrap that around like that, secure it to the flat on the end. See how the boat just naturally wants to turn hard, turns hard to starboard, and it's just because of the way the propeller, the way the engine turns, and consequently the way the propeller turns. Hard to start at almost every single time. There's three. But at least one more down here, since we're already down here. Let's go get it. And that's how I get them, you know, and we'll see if we can get something. We'll let you know. We may need to put the jugs up closer to the dam, but not too close. And we'll have to go from there. I'll be back with you once we get them all in and see what we got. Don't talk. Nothing on the jugs. Just can't get the catfish for nothing. So we're just going to go brim. Maybe just end up brim fishing the rest of the season.